Trendy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're gonna talk about a Brous Blades knife. So this one is also one that was lent to me by Nico from Greece. He has the Instagram channel today's_grails_tomorrowspeeders, where he shares his vast and pretty high-end knife collection with all of you. And if you're interested, please check him out. You will find a link in the description below as well. And he lent me his Brous Caliber in the G10 version. There is also a carbon fiber version of this knife available. These knives are or were limited to about 300 pieces each. I think 300 carbon fiber and 300 in the G10 here. And this one is number 167 of 300. So Brous Blades loves to do those limited runs. I think most of his knives are limited to a certain number. And this is one of the earlier Brous Blades. You also can see that by the box in the back. But he also got a certificate with this one here. You can see it's from 2015. You have his signature there. And it states that it's a limited run of 300 pieces and that they are semi-custom blades by their own definition. And here you can see the materials that are used. G10 for the handle scales. Then you have D2 tool steel. Brous only uses D2 tool steel as far as I know. And you can see he has a pretty nice hardness there. And you have all his information down there on the certificate as well. So pretty classy. I like when makers give you this certificate. It just is an extra touch that you get for your knife. But now let's take a look at the knife itself. You can see it's a smaller overall package. We have an overall length of 7 inches or 17.8 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 3 inches or 7.6 centimeters. We have a blade stock of 4 millimeters that thins out quite rapidly because of the full sweat shear that gives it that dagger style blade shape. The steel is, as I said before, D2, and we have a handle length of 4 inches or 10.2 centimeters. So pretty interesting overall specs, right in my wheelhouse actually, with the overall size. You can see you have a pretty interesting design and grip that forces you a little bit back into this position. So it's not a very universal handle. You actually only can hold it like this, or maybe in a reverse grip, but that doesn't work that well as well. So you mostly will use this knife like this, in this sort of a pistol grip fashion, which is certainly an interesting design, but not my favorite way of holding a knife, because you really feel a little bit pushed back that way because of this choil there. And it's also not that large of a choil. I don't have pretty large fingers, but even I feel a little bit cramped in this first finger choil right there. But it works, and it's also quite comfortable, but this one should be a little bit larger. You also have a little bit harder corner here in the G10. The weight on the Brous Caliber comes in at around 98 grams or 3.5 ounces, and that is quite a good weight, I think, for the construction here with your 4 millimeters of blade stock and your steel liners that have been quite nicely skeletonized and milled out. You can see that on both sides, large chunks are milled out of quite substantial stainless steel liners. So I think the 3.5 ounces, pretty good weight here for a knife like this. One of the most interesting features here is the blade shape and the grind on the caliber. You can see it's a really dagger inspired blade shape. I would call it a spear point here, with this very large swatch at the top that nearly goes into the middle of the whole blade. And then you have a hollow grind here for the primary bevel, and a satin finish on it that actually looks quite nice. It's not a very fine satin, but it just looks pretty nice, and I'm normally not that big of a fan of a satin finish. I really would have liked to see a two-tone, where you have a DLC coating or a stonewash here on the flat portion. But even as it is quite an attractive and very unique looking blade for a folding flipper here with that dagger inspired blade. Of course, the steel is D2, so not entirely stainless. You have to keep a light coat of oil on it if you want to go the safe route while storing and using this knife. But other than that, it has a great edge retention. It's pretty easy to resharpen, and also the toughness is quite good. So certainly not that bad of a steel. but it seems to be a little bit hard to get a very fine edge out of this steel, so it takes a little bit of a toothier edge than some other steels. And at the price point of this knife, I think the D2 steel is a little bit outdated, and I don't really know why Brous keeps insisting on only using D2. I would like to see his knives come out in M390, 20CV, S35, LC200N, and some other steels. Just vary a little bit, branch out a little bit, and just don't stick to your D2, or even go to CPM D2 in the powder metallurgy process. So this is just a regular D2, certainly a good usable steel, but nothing really impressive. You can also see that you have a pretty nice sharpening choil there, but the edge termination here is done a little bit flared out, and you can see that you also are not that thin behind the edge, even though it's a hollow grind. So maybe here he could have done a little bit better. But maybe he also did this on purpose, why we're gonna see a little bit later on in the video. Also, tip strength is nice for a knife of this size, nice and thin, good for detailed work. And the blade shape is something that you really have to like. I think it's interesting, but I wouldn't buy this for myself. It just doesn't fit my EDC uses that great. There are no markings on the blade, as you can see on both sides. Very sterile blade, I quite like that. You only have the serial number marking here on the bottom, and then no Brous Blades marking or anything like that. You only can find that on the clip. Maybe I would have liked to see a Brous Blades mark here on the flat portion. If you take a look at the handle construction and the action, we can see that we have quite smooth G10 scales here, riding up on quite thick and skeletonized stainless steel liners. The construction is done with Torx screws. You can see some smaller ones here for the body screws running on standoffs. And then here we have a larger pivot screw, also Torx adjustable on both sides. Other interesting features are this little inserted tab that works as your very, very small lanyard attachment point, and you actually can swap the pocket clip, which is a nice overloop pocket clip. And I have to state that this one has been accidentally bent out of shape by Nico while he was carrying this knife, so this would actually not stick up that far from the handle. It would more look like this and also be a little more in this direction. But I actually like the design of the pocket clip. You have a lot of ramp here and a nice deep carry clip, and you can swap it around while swapping it with this little lanyard attachment point. So that is for tip up left or right side carry. So pretty well executed here on the pocket clip. It also hides in the pocket really well. Unobtrusive clip here by Brous Blades, and also the marking is done quite nicely. This one has a little bit of wear on it, as you can see here. A negative thing on this little protrusion here that works as your filler tab and your lanyard attachment point is actually that it digs a bit in your hand when you're opening the flipper. You can see I hold the knife like this when I flip it and rest it on this palm of my hand right there, and then I flip it and it digs in there quite a bit. Maybe you can see that here, that you have a little bit of a print from digging in of this quite thin piece of steel. So maybe he could just do a flush mounted filler tab or something different, but this certainly is also too small for most lanyards out there, so it's a little bit of an odd choice of filler tab there. But other than that, ergonomically, I said before, you feel a little bit forced in that particular grip right here. You have some nice jimping at the top, which is a little bit soft. Maybe that could be slightly more aggressive because you can easily rub all over the place right there. But it's nice that he thought about some texturing up there. Then you can see you have some milled out portions here on both sides of the liner, so that if you're flipping your flipper tab, you land on a nice spot and not on the corners of the liners, which are actually also not that sharp. Nicely finished there as well, but there is a big issue with these millings on the inside, because you can see when I close the knife up that the edge is right there. Maybe I can show you this up close. The edge is right there where you're going to land with your flipper tab, and you can actually just touch it with your finger very easily when the knife is closed. So if you run your finger around here, you're gonna catch that and it could slice you. But at this point, it's not that particularly sharp, as I showed you before, and that was why I thought he maybe did that on purpose. But this is just bad design. You can see how far that sticks out of the handle there. It just should have made the handle a little bit broader or slimmed the blade a little bit down, but this is very dangerous and not good design in my opinion. And even because the D10 is a little bit strong here on this knife, I sometimes slip off the flipper tab like this and just land right with all the pressure on my finger in that corner there of the edge, and that is just very bad in my opinion. That just is really a dangerous thing here on this folding knife. And also the flipper tab could use some jimping here on the forward face right here, because you can slip up because it has quite a strong detent. On the centering, we can see here that is actually quite nicely done, pretty much perfect. Lock up, we have no side to side, no up and down play on this stainless steel liner lock. You can see that you actually have quite a early lock up there, but maybe you have heard it during the review, there is actually some lock stick, even though these are steel liners, you have some lock stick there, and I wasn't able to get that away. So I tried graphite, I tried cleaning the lock face and everything, but this lock stick just stays there. You can hear that probably. There is some noticeable stick there, and that is just a little bit odd for me personally. Really feels a little bit janky. You also have some grittiness in the action, as you can feel that. So if I disengage the lock bar, it is a little bit free falling, but then it just has a little bit of a grainy or a gritty action. Maybe you can hear that as well. Not very smooth here, and the same was the case with my inside, not that great of an action. And at the price point that these knives come in, I really don't see why they can't perfect the action. It runs on a ball bearing pivot, their proprietary ball bearing pivot that they use on all of their knives, but maybe it's just some gunk got in the pivot there, because it is a used knife from Nico and I haven't opened it up and cleaned it. But the action is just not that impressive. Now let's come to some size comparisons. And first off, I have a knife from ZT, the 0460. Also a nice premium blade here, made in the US, as well as the Brous, of course. Here we have a carbon fiber show scale, titanium frame lock, and S35 VN blade on a KVT ball bearing system. And here you can see size-wise, those two are actually quite similar. The caliber is slightly smaller there, and here of course I have a much nicer action, as you can see here. Then the next comparison I have for you is the Three Rivers Class Action Flipper, a nice US made smaller flipper that is also smaller as the caliber. You can see that here, nice milled titanium, great clip there, just overall an awesome little flipper, also with an action that is much nicer and much snappier than the caliber right there. And the last comparison I have for is probably the knife that comes the closest to the caliber here, and that is the Kaiser Barbosa from their Vanguard line. So here we have a VG10 steel blade, G10 handle case, a steel liner lock, standoffs in the back, an overloop deep carry clip that is mounted a little bit low on the handle, and just an overall quite similar size. And also the feel of these knives is actually surprisingly similar. I even have to say that I probably like especially the action here on the Kaiser better, also the texturing on the G10, and just the overall feel feels a little bit more refined to me. Also, I'm not that forced in a particular grip on the Barbosa here. The action is certainly much nicer, and just the overall feel and quality that you get here from this Kaiser feels just nicer than here on the Brous. This feels a little bit unfinished to me, has a lot of weird design choices, like for example this one here, which is really a deal breaker for me personally, I have to say, and just feels a little bit unfinished somehow, which is quite surprising at the price point there. The sharpness on this knife, I said before, it's a used knife from my good friend Nico. But the sharpness is actually quite nice. I don't know if he's dropped or sharpened it, but it pretty much looks like a factory edge there. And it actually slices quite well. Also, for some EDC tasks, the blade shape performs quite well because it's a hollow grind, which I actually like. But the blade shape is just nothing that I can get too excited about. I really prefer drop points, regular drop points, or just worn cliffs for my EDC user knives, or an Insingo from Chris Reeve, for example, which is more of a sheep's foot. But sharpness wise, I can fold this knife. It's quite sharp and also performed pretty well in the limited use that I had with it. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about the Brous Blades Caliber in the G10 edition. And I think value is probably the weakest part here on this Brous Blades, as well as it was on the inside that I had. It just seems that these Brous Blades are overpriced in my personal opinion. There is too much going on there that feels unfinished, that feels not really thought through, like the edge sticking out of the handle when the knife is closed. Also, the fit and finish is not at the level that I would like to see it for the $200 that Brous Blades has charged for these knives in the past. Now I think they are sold out. And also the materials that you are getting here are not on par in comparison to everything else that is out there on the market at this price point. The materials are good. G10 and T2 are certainly good materials for folding knives, but more in the $50 to maybe $80 range and not at $200. Of course, it's US made. That certainly charges a little bit of a premium compared to some of these other Chinese offerings, but even with that, I certainly cannot see the $200. I had two experiences with Brous Blade now, and both of them were not very impressive, to say the least. So not really a knife or a company that I would recommend to check out from the experience that I had. But I would love to hear your experience that you had with Brous Blades. Do you like their knives? Have you handled them? Do you own them and love them? Please put that down in the comments and let me know what you have experienced with this brand or this particular model, the Brous Caliber. So overall, I really can't recommend this knife personally. If you're just searching for a nice EDC blade with that sort of material mixture, I could recommend something like this, the Kaiser Barbosa, or some of the budget lines of Best Tech, where you get D2 and G10 great action at around $50 to $60. So that probably would be the better route to go. Of course, they are Chinese made. So this was my review of the Brous Caliber. Unfortunately, it was a negative one. I don't like to be negative, but if there are some glaring issues like we have them here, I certainly have to call them out. And if you like the review, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or experiences with Brous Blades that you want to share in the comments, please do so. And if you want to see more of these knife gunning gear use, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.